problem
object
also,
val red
we are
value.
using the same date type of structured variable. However, in this problem, we would like to explain how we can pass date type of objects and also date type of pointers to the functions and manipulate them. We have written a function readDate such that it takes a date type of variable address. In that function, we wanted to read data for the date type of variable. So if you wanted some changes to be carried out in the function and those modifications should be visible in the other programs, then what is the solution? That is passing by address. Thus, here also we are sending the address of a date type of variable for which we wanted data to be read. Thus, the function is being written as getting date type of address as argument. As usual, A in that function is a date type of pointer. Thus, in order to access the data members of the date type of pointer, ARD, AROM, AROY been used. They are integers. We wanted to read the data into those integers. So simply we have used ampersand. We did write another function known as printDate. The main intention of this function is just to print the data values of a date type of object. We don't require to change anything. Thus, this function is written such a way that it takes the date type of object as an argument, not the address. And the main program is written such a way that it takes a date type of variable, that is, it declares a date type of variable, and then sends the address of that one to readDate function and simply prints the date type of object value by calling the printDate function. For the purpose of demonstration, we are taking a table in which how the memory activities takes place while the program is running is displayed. We assume that memory for the variable x, the date type of variable x, is allocated because we are declaring that variable x, and we assume that its address starts from 10018. The same 10018 will be sent to the readDate function. In that, data will be read as 15/08/1963. It is shown in the table. When readDate function is called, memory for the variables in that function, that is A, will be allocated. From the main, we are sending the address of the variable x, that is 10018. Thus, A value becomes 10018, which is pointing to the address of this variable x. We assume that the user has entered date value as 15/08/1963. It is being stored in x.d, x.m, x.y. When the program execution returns from the main this function readDate, the memory which is allocated for this variable A in that function, that gets deallocated. Now the program is now in the main program. Now printDate function is called. X is sent as an argument for that function. However, in that function we have A as a date type of variable as an argument. Thus, memory for that A will be allocated. That is, for A.d, A.m, A.y, memory will be allocated. x dot d, that is 15 is assigned to a dot d. 8, that is x dot m is assigned to a dot m. x dot y is assigned to a dot y of the function. That is, when we send a date type of object as an argument, then member by member copying takes place in the function. Thus, x dot d is assigned to a dot d, x dot m is assigned to a dot m, x dot y is assigned to a dot y. Now a dot d, a dot m, a dot y values are printed. That is, they are nothing but x dot d, x dot m, x dot y. Thus, we will see the content of x on the screen. Now the memory which is allocated for a dot y is deallocated. Now the memory which was allocated for a dot m, it will be deallocated. Now the memory which was allocated for that a dot d will be also deallocated. Thus, whatever memory is allocated for the data members of the function, that is the formal arguments of the function, they will be now deallocated when we return from that function.
Problem object also, we are using the same